Over 300,000 homes on the U.S. coast could flood every 2 weeks in 30 years' time, shocking report finds. Across the United States, 311,000 coastal homes with a collective market value of about $120 billion are at risk of chronic flooding by 2045, a report has found. According to the Union of Concerned Scientists study, every one of the 23 states along every coastline in the United States, except for Hawaii and Alaska, are at risk. This analysis estimates the number of homes and commercial properties throughout the coastal United States that will be put at risk from chronic inundation, defined as flooding that occurs 26 times per year or more. The study's authors drew their conclusions after an in-depth study of the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's sea level rise projections, combined with data from the Zillow real estate website. By century's end, if current trends continue, more than $1 trillion in commercial and private U.S. property may be at risk. States with the most homes at risk by the end of the century are Florida, with about 1 million homes or more than 10% of the state's current residential properties, followed by New Jersey with 250,000 homes, and New York with 143,000 homes. As many as 64,000 coastal residences worth $26 billion in Florida are at risk of chronic flooding in the next 30 years, the life of a typical mortgage. By 2045, rising seas are expected to bring an extra 1.8 feet of water along Florida's coast, according to the UCS report. By 2100, Florida can expect an average of 6.4 extra feet of water. A large figure lot given that the state's average elevation above sea level is only about 6 feet, with many places 3 feet or below. The danger comes from flooding due to high tides, sometimes called sunny day floods, or nuisance flooding, when water washes into streets, sidewalks, storefronts and homes. The flooding could lead to an economic crisis, with waterlogged homes someday becoming unsafe, uninhabitable and too costly to insure. The impact could well be staggering, said Christina Dahl, a senior climate scientist at the Union of Concerned Scientists, UCS, told The Guardian. This level of flooding would be a tipping point where people in these communities would think it's unsustainable. Even homes along the Gulf Coast that are elevated would be affected, as they'd have to drive through salt water to get to work or face their kids' school being cut off. You can imagine people walking away from mortgages, away from their homes. Rachel Cletus, lead economist and policy director with the Climate and Energy Program at the UCS, added, "This risk is relatively near term, well before places go underwater completely, and even in the absence of storms." The projections use a high-end scenario for sea level rise because that is an appropriately conservative projection to use when estimating risk to homes, often people's largest asset, Cletus said. "This is a slow-moving disaster," she said.